Coming to Northeast Wisconsin live from the Civic Media Studios at the City Deck Landing in Green Bay and featuring TV and radio broadcast veteran John Maino, along with the City of Green Bay's longest serving mayor, Jim Schmidt. This is Maino and the Mayor. Here are your hosts, John Maino and Jim Schmidt.
Good morning. It is Thursday. It is draft day. It is a nice morning out there. No wind. Green Bay, 29 degrees. Appleton, 34. Oshkosh, 30. Why would Appleton be higher when it's right in between Green Bay and Oshkosh?
I don't know. These
weather, all right, we got to ask Brittany that
these,
next time.
These weather people. These weather people just make it up.
So. Hey, happy. We got a good show today, folks, including Larry the Rock McCarron.
Yes.
We'll be coming out at 7 o'clock.
To talk about the draft.
To talk about the draft. Today is my favorite animal day.
Oh, nice.
Really? Since
my
when?
Favorite? No, always. Even in art class one time, we had to do, I should have told this to Naomi when I had her on the other day. We had to do paper mache things with animals.
Yeah.
And mine was a penguin.
Really?
I love penguins.
Why?
I think we have the same length legs.
That is true. You walk the same.
Yeah. I would love to have a penguin as a pet.
You should have worn a tux today in honor of Penguin Day, Johnny.
I would love to have a penguin as a pet.
Oof.
I think penguins are cool. They don't bother anybody. They just do their thing.
You don't know that. They look cute. They look like they don't bother people. But it's like that lady that had that little orangutan in New York.
And got her face beaten off.
No, he did her in eventually. Yeah. But yeah,
or the guy, or Sharon Stone's husband. Who had a gecko? No, not a gecko.
What did he have?
This big lizard type thing ate his foot.
Yeah, see, you don't know those penguins, man.
That I don't know.
I think that could be
okay.
Just a disguise behind that tux.
But the thing is, like in the UP, I could have one where it's, you know, when we have our place off the grid.
Yeah.
And they'd be in the snow all the time. We'd have a lake and a sauna and the whole thing.
You know, I think that'd be cool to have. Like, and you could just sit around and watch the penguins.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
I
add that.
Love penguins.
Okay. I didn't know that until today.
National Penguin Day.
Yes.
Yeah.
Kimono Dragon.
Kimono Dragon. Yeah. And it like ate his foot, right?
Yeah.
I know
well,
he lost
part
some
of it,
toes.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And then Sharon Stone dumped him.
She actually, yeah, wouldn't you? I mean, really?
Yeah, well, she actually called me that day. Said, hey, I'm breaking up. How you doing?
Are you still available?
I'm back on.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I said, no, sorry.
And at that time, we made out to Mahogany, the theme of Mahogany. And then Ben.
Olivia and John.
Ben.
And now I like women.
Ben.
Yeah.
The two of us. Hey,
John,
okay,
you
now
turned,
you're getting a little personal.
No, that was a great
she
story.
She went out with you, and then she turned to the same sex. That's a little weird, John. And you kind of, like the way you told the story, it's kind of like you were taking credit for it. I was like.
I don't know if you should
I don't
be
know,
proud
John.
Of that.
Yeah. I pushed her over the edge.
Yeah. Right. I don't want this.
All
yeah.
right.
Okay.
Fine. Wow. It's telephone day. I don't know what that means exactly, Todd.
Well, I think you just celebrate the telephone.
The telephone. You know what I wish I could go back? When I worked in this one mine, it was the ore improvement plant, and I got sent. There was a terrible place to work, and I got sent there as a punishment for what I had done the year before in the mine, okay? I did. I should have gotten fired, but my dad was a big wheel, and I was the only summer student ever to file a grievance against my boss.
Not a good idea.
No.
Should have called me. But,
yeah,
okay.
Not a good idea. So they sent me the ore improvement plant, which was just this nasty place. And I remember when I played softball every year, they had to throw my jersey away at the end of the season because when I would sweat red from the ore dust that was so in my pores that when I sweat, it was red. Honest to God.
Really?
Even if I woke, if I slept, you know, and
it was in your.
It's so in your, it gets so ingrained. It was so fine. And I remember even T-shirts I had to throw. To wake up, you know, you sweat at night sometimes.
Yeah.
And that red stain would be on me. You couldn't get rid of it.
So where is the Siberia of mining? Did you have to go? Did you have to travel to go?
Or
was it next door to the good mine? You got sent to a.
That's probably about 8 miles.
Okay. All right.
So it's in Eagle Mills, it's called in the UP, outside of Marquette, between Marquette and Nagani. It was the worst place to work that there was.
Okay. You filed a grievance against your boss, which you should talk
in
to your
fact,
dad
In fact, you know
first.
What? A dairy had to close down and sued them because it was ruining their milk even. The sky, they was so nasty. You know the song, Paul Simon, in My Little Town, mm-hmm. and all of the things were black or whatever? It was like that, but it was red. If there's anybody from the UP that remembers the Eagle Mills pellet plant or the ore improvement plant, let me know. It was horrific, and that's what they sent me there as a punishment. Wow. But anyway, the long story short, one of my jobs, then it was going to be closing down, so you had to, like, get rid of all this stuff. It was a great job, you know, getting rid of stuff. And one of the things I had to do one day, take to the dump, was, like, 20 old-fashioned telephones. You know the crank kind? I think on, like, a Petticoat Junction.
You should have held on
They used
to
use those. I know! They're, like, $500 a piece, yeah, though, or $1,000 right. a piece. I threw about 25 of those.
Oh,
I remember
man.
It perfectly, throwing them into the dump, and then they got buried up. And those are such collector items now in New York and places. It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
Yeah. I almost thought, it's like, where do we dump those? I wonder if they're still there. But they had the old crank on them.
Oh, yeah.
And
those
thing.
Are all in the movies.
Yes.
Yeah, that's
exactly
cool.
The ones from the movies. I so wish I still had those. Isn't that something? I don't know why I didn't steal one. I remember throwing them away. I wouldn't even be stealing.
And even if it was stealing, I wouldn't have bothered you.
No.
All right. Well, that's too bad.
But anyway, that's my story. But yeah, the ore improvement plant. You can't believe how nasty it was. But anyway, today's also Lingerie Day, okay? All righty.
How will you celebrate that?
I don't know. How do we celebrate Lingerie Day?
Why don't they call it Lingerie Night?
Yeah.
Okay, well, yeah, I don't know, John.
Did you ever buy lingerie for anybody?
Yes.
I never did. I was always, okay. You know what? Can I be honest with you? Even when I walked through Walmart.
Yeah.
Well, I sure would buy lingerie at Walmart. Oh, my God. Okay, whatever. Go ahead, John.
Can you yes. take that clip and make a promo?
Let me write that down. 612.
I never
47.
Buy my lingerie at Walmart. Can you do that?
Wouldn't you? Okay,
yes. I'm just saying.
Okay, so Christmas Eve, Victoria's Secrets, it's all guys buying that stuff.
I can't do it.
I ran into Mike Holmgren there.
No!
I swear to God.
No!
Yeah,
oh my gosh. So all I'm saying is when you walk through Walmart, okay? And I walk past the women's underwear section, I can't look at it. I'm really uncomfortable. I could never do that. I could never go into a store like that and buy something for somebody. It makes me really uncomfortable. I literally sometimes put my hand like this so I don't see it. Isn't that weird?
Yeah.
Analyze that.
What's so weird about?
It makes me really uncomfortable.
Are you uncomfortable when you check out, or are you just uncomfortable with the whole?
Well, I don't buy anything. Just seeing it, that makes me
walking past it.
Walking past it.
What did you do? Don't you have?
No, that makes me really uncomfortable. I could never by myself go into a Victoria's Secrets type thing. Mm-hmm. Never. Just makes me uncomfortable. Isn't that weird?
And the checkout girls are always super friendly.
I would not know.
She's going to like this. I'm like, well.
Never been to one. Never. No.
Would you try it on? No.
Nope. Oh, my God.
Wait, what?
I didn't say that.
Jim.
I didn't say that.
Another clip.
That was the guy in front of me. That was the guy in front of me.
Right.
That was the guy in front of me.
It's kind of like Christmas Vacation when Chevy Chase is there. He's like, that's a little bit nipply out.
Absolutely.
So Lingerie Day, that's nice. So you're not going to go buy your wife
again. Oh, God. I could never do that. Never in a million years could I do that.
I don't understand. I don't think I understand.
I think a lot
that.
Of guys are like
you have
that.
Daughters too.
Still, I want nothing to do with it. Nothing.
Okay, I got to think that one through.
I think a lot of guys are like that.
No,
No,
they're not. Guys,
I bet. Okay, quick. Let me just say.
Okay,
go ahead.
This is why guys are going to say no because of the creepy guy that stands in the aisle,
right.
feeling it. Okay,
that's you.
No.
Oh, I thought that's what you meant.
No, I'm saying that's. The guy at Walmart. I think, did you ever buy your wife feminine products?
Oh my God, he almost puked.
No.
You never did that.
I'm real queasy about stuff like that.
Oh my God,
Jim.
John, what if she...
No! I don't want to know a single thing about what women do with whatever. No. Nothing.
Okay, let me ask you this.
Nothing. No,
okay,
don't
this
even...
is the last
oh,
question.
God.
This is the last question I'm going to ask you. Were you in the delivery room when your wife...
No, well, I was, but I had my eyes closed.
John, that's like...
Okay. I'm not even kidding you. I had my eyes closed. What?
Okay, I wouldn't have guessed that about you. I don't know y'all
so
that well.
I'm so squeamish on certain things.
Yeah, I guess so.
You can't believe it.
Well, buying lingerie,
guys,
that's
have
like
you ever
total,
bought lingerie
total wussy.
For your girlfriends or your wife or both of them or neither of them or
at
whatever?
The same day.
Exactly. Let us know.
That's the poll this morning.
That's
Make sure
the poll.
Download the Civic Media app and choose your station and then text in the lower right hand.
Today's
National Lingerie Day. Have you ever bought lingerie for your woman?
Right.
Okay.
That's.
I say no. I'm the first
okay,
one. No.
Okay. Just wait. Let's get a percent. And we're going to put money on this?
Yeah.
Okay.
$10.
All right. $10. I will say.
It's up to what? $60?
Tell you what, Todd? Let's just do this.
Well, this is separate.
This is
we could put it in the same poll if you want.
Oh, if you want to.
In the same pot.
Yeah. Right now we're at $60 on our fines.
Okay. Johnny, should we make it? I'm going to say it's over 50%. You're going to say it's less than 50%?
Yes.
Much less. So pick a number.
40.
Okay. All right. So that's fine. I'm going to say it's over 50%.
I'm going to say 30. Quick poll. It's on the thing. Todd's putting up there. Men, are you uncomfortable buying lingerie for someone?
Are you comfortable?
Are you comfortable?
Yes.
Buying lingerie. I think it's just, have you ever bought? Yes or no?
Okay.
Because people can say I'm not comfortable, but yeah, I bought it because she's my wife.
I think most guys have not.
But I think the question, that's a second question. Are you comfortable or not is not the same as did you buy it or not.
Well, either way. Okay. Todd, for Jim's sake, just so I don't have to put up with this all day.
Oh my gosh.
Can you change it for him?
I was researching the 12th Amendment last night, trying to get that flipped.
Yeah. Oh my God. People are like, wow, he was mayor and you beat him.
Yeah, I know.
It's like, wow, that'd be like him beating you on quarterbacks.
Yeah, I wouldn't even try. Yeah.
Got here. Men, have you bought lingerie for someone? Yes or no?
So Is that good, Jim?
That's a yes or no question. And okay. John says it's going to be 30%. Yeah. No, that was comfortable. They could say I bought it, but I was super uncomfortable. Okay. And this is a good question. And I'm saying the answer is going to be yes, over 50% of men have bought lingerie for someone.
Okay. I say no.
Okay.
All right.
This is going to be interesting. Todd, what do you think?
Have you, Todd?
I have.
Oh,
see, that's 2-1 right now, Johnny.
That's like, hey, you know what? We always talk about how personal Todd is. He doesn't share too much of his personal life.
I mean,
that's the most he's ever shared with us.
No, yeah. Remember the story about Madonna?
That was a great story. I had a lot of people texting me saying, finish the story. Zucchini bread day. I love zucchini bread. Love it, love it, love it. Renee Zellweger's birthday. Joe Buck. I love Joe Buck. Al Pacino. Oh, my gosh.
When I saw that, I thought, okay.
Can I do some Al Pacino
quotes? I knew we were going to hear that. He's 84. I didn't think. Yeah, I guess that's
out of order. This whole room is out of order.
That was
if I was half the man I was 5 years ago, I'd take a flamethrower to this place. Hoo-ah.
Oh, man.
Quick poll. So far, men, have you bought lingerie for someone? 75% no, 25% yes.
Okay, come on, you guys.
Quick
call
break.
In.
Back after this.
Call in. We won't tell anybody.
That's it. That's the one, Todd. From the R Improvement Plant.
In where?
Eagle Mills. Eagle Mills, Michigan.
But the plant's closed.
Yeah. Men, have you bought lingerie for someone? I said no. Our poll so far, no. 75, yes, 25.
Come on, you guys. I mean, come on.
Can I be honest with you on this?
Yeah.
And I don't mean to get in a woman's head here, okay? I don't think women like that when guys do that.
Oh.
Because let's be honest, okay, we're on thin ice here. We got to be careful what we're saying.
Yes.
Okay. All I'm saying is
family
this.
Show.
Okay, what I'm saying is this: whether guys admit it or not, they're not buying that out of concern and whatever for the
show
woman.
Love, right?
Come
right.
on,
hey, John.
You know what
yes,
I mean?
You don't know that. That's a whole different question.
If you buy jewelry, that's because you're whatever. Okay. You don't do it for them. It's not like some woman's going to say, oh, my gosh, thank you so much for this thong. True or not? True or false, Todd?
Well, you know.
Yeah, true. You got this text here. My husband once stopped at Walgreens at 3 a.m. because I needed a product. I'm not even going to say the word.
Feminine. That's what's wrong with that.
Oh, he was working as a law enforcement officer, all 6'6" of him. The clerk looked up and couldn't stop laughing. He said, what? There's an emergency at home.
Exactly. All exactly.
Right. Okay.
Those checkout girls.
I'm so squeamish with stuff like
if
that.
If you do that and go through the line, they look at you like, man, I hope my husband's like you someday.
No, I don't think so.
Yeah. I bet they do, Jim.
They do. They look at
I think so.
And especially the young ones, 18, 19, 20, they're like, man, this is cool.
Yeah. I don't even want to talk
You can't even say the word feminine?
No, I can't.
Really?
Okay, wow. John, okay.
I'm squeamish, so I just got certain things that are just, I can't. But don't you agree with me? Don't both you guys agree with me? If a guy buys lingerie for their woman, they're doing it for themselves, that they're going to get a little something out of it. True or false? Jim?
Yeah, that would be over 75%.
Okay. Thank you. Right now it's 65% no, 35% yes. Have you bought lingerie for somebody here on National Lingerie Day? When we have Larry McCarron on, we have a rock on it. About half an hour. I'm going to ask him.
He might not admit that, John.
He would have. Because it, do I know what his going? No.
No, he's he won't
he's
admit.
He's going to buddy cuz. Yep. Nope.
He might not admit because of the second question you asked. You're
doing it for your guys. You're yourself. Doing it for yourself. Right. Admit it. Come on. Oh. I'm just saying. How do we get on this topic?
It was
National Lingerie Day. That's right. That's
National Lingerie Day.
That's
right.
So we're celebrating that. And with the celebration of National Lingerie Day, we're taking a poll.
Yes.
And we, guys who are
65%,
listening.
65%. Oh, it's changed. 40, okay.
40,
well,
60.
60, 40 now.
So
no.
Have you ever bought lingerie for someone? So we're not saying could be your girlfriend, could be your wife, could be your kids.
Could be both.
Could be whatever. Both. Right. So anyway.
If you got a girlfriend and a wife?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay. Different kinds.
Yeah. one's probably a different size than the
right,
other.
Different size. Different kind. Okay.
One gets Walmart, the right, other one yeah, gets exactly. Victoria's right. Secret.
Here's the flannel.
Are there still Victoria's Secret stores?
I think so.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, okay. There are.
A lot of stuff's online. Don't you get those like magazines at home? You don't. Okay. All right. Forget it.
I know in my case.
Not you, but like your wife.
She would be very uncomfortable if I did that.
Yeah. Like maybe, and you guys, what qualifies for this is Packer lingerie.
What do you mean?
You're getting your wife or your girlfriend, you know. It's
Packer lingerie. There's Packer lingerie?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
There is not.
All right. What else?
There's pack. What do you mean by Packer lingerie?
I'm going to look it up.
Okay. He's looking. Okay. There is.
There is Packer lingerie? That kind of seems like an oxymoron, doesn't it? From Packers to sexy time.
So I have to be careful what I look up in here because I looked up Packer lingerie and a ton of stuff came up.
You know, you had some other thing last week. And I went to look up, and it's like, wow, did that bring me to some bad sites? I forget what it was.
It was Todd Michaels.
No, something. I forget what it was. Todd, do you have Julie's number real quick?
I don't think I have it.
Okay. We're going to make her really uncomfortable real quick.
Oh, that poor woman.
Yeah, John, let her alone.
Oh, just relax.
Where is my... Okay. Todd, the poll on Packer lingerie, they do offer that, and you can buy that, and a lot of it's bought
at the pro shop.
Well,
you can definitely
online.
Get it online.
Yeah, online, I'm sure it's in the pro
really?
Shop too.
Wow. Okay.
Dude, John.
Todd's putting some pictures up on her thing. Is that Packer? Wow, it is. It really is. There's even the
yes,
G.
Yes, it is.
Yes.
Okay. Wow.
Right.
I've never
position
seen that.
Of the logo.
Absolutely. We've never heard of that. Never. Yeah. Like I said, we get Larry McCarron on. In half an hour, we're going to ask him about this.
Okay.
Maybe he's an advocate of it. Did you get my text there, Todd, real quick?
Oh, let me check that real quick.
I could see you being a guy that would buy a lot of stuff, like the interesting stuff for your... I got this absolutely for the mail, but it's called Adding Spark to the Bedroom. Just got
okay,
this text.
That's all right.
Okay, then. All right. Yeah.
You know.
So, yeah. All right, yeah. I don't think I ever have in my lifetime.
But
in my life, yes, for a woman. Ever. I'm a lot more squeamish than you would think.
Yeah.
In a lot of things.
Because you're pretty tough. You come across as a pretty tough guy.
And I'm actually very squeamish on a lot of stuff. Hmm. So I'm just throwing that out there.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So that's national. We're gonna take this poll. I want to pick it up again.
But I'm still winning. No, 60% to 40.
Yeah. Okay. It's also 626.
Hello. Hey, go ahead, caller.
Hello.
Julie, hey. Your husband, I'm learning about him this morning, and I've been working with him for 10 months. He's kind of a squish.
I'm a lot more squeamish than people
think. He is very squeamish. Oh, my gosh. For Mr. Tough Guy, he's very squeamish.
That's what I said. So we're talking today's National Lingerie Day. We're talking about, you know, women, girlfriends, whatever. And I said, have you ever bought feminine products for your wife?
Don't even talk about that. And, no. Or they said, please,
go,
no.
Go get me
what
some of these.
What do you think? Oh, well,
I thought, yes.
Oh, God.
You guys send us out.
My God.
Go.
Okay, forget. Okay,
go to the store right now.
Okay, let me ask you something.
Okay.
Can I ask her a question?
Oh, yes, Julie.
Can I ask you a question? I know others bought you lingerie, but did I ever buy you lingerie?
Stop.
Others.
It even creeps her out.
Yeah. I know. Did I ever buy you lingerie? Did I ever buy you lingerie?
Have you ever?
Yeah.
It's never happened.
There you go.
Nope.
Now, okay, let me ask you a question, Julie. If he did, would you feel comfortable receiving it?
From John?
Yes.
Probably not.
From John. Okay, how about from the mayor? Yeah.
Okay. I'm interested.
Well, let's take a turn.
Yeah, all right.
Wow.
Right.
But don't you agree? I'm uncomfortable even being around those sections of a store?
Yes.
I don't get that.
Yeah. I don't either, but I've had to live with it for 30 years.
All right, we'll refocus on National Zucchini Bread Day. This is going nowhere.
Probably better.
Yeah. We will.
All right,
Julie.
All right.
Have a great day.
You bet. You too.
See ya. So there you go. That verifies it. Yeah,
it did.
That you does. Okay. Yep. Absolutely. All right, we got a fun show coming up. As we mentioned, Larry McCarron coming on. We got a guy that is living my dream about building little houses.
Chad.
We got Greasy Fingers Barbershop coming up. We got Brewer tickets we're giving away, a bunch of them.
And great seats, too, by the way. Those are good seats.
Stay with us.
Civic has good seats.
Civic Media app today from the Apple Store or Google Play Store. And text the studio directly, all from the Civic Media app. Download it today. Now, once again, here's Maino and the Mayor, John Maino and Jim Schmidt.
Hey, thank you very much. Welcome back. Maino and the Mayor here on a good-looking Thursday morning. Our quick poll, men, have you ever bought lingerie for someone on National Lingerie Day? So far, it's no, 60 to 40. 60 to 40.
634.
60 to 40. So I'm winning that one.
And
I just won $10 from him, Todd.
Oh, he did.
I did. I legitimately just won
$10. Just tell the story.
No, we were just talking about the village presidents of Ashwaubenon because Johnny had dealt with some of his veterans work. And, of course, I dealt with a lot of them because we worked with the village of Ashwaubenon. And I named the presidents back. Five in a row, and he goes, nope, this guy was a president. I said, no, he wasn't, Johnny. I just named them all for you.
He was adamant.
I was.
I know every president. I worked with them. Okay, you think I don't know every president? I worked with them, okay? I was mayor. I worked with them. And then I said the name, and you said...
I forgot about him.
$10.
Let's give it a little...
Thank you. Boy, between beating you in the civics test yesterday, and
I'm still contesting some of that.
I don't think you can anymore. Yeah. So anyway.
So now let me ask you a question. Jim, this would be up to you because I know you're the ruler of all things.
Yes,
men, have you bought lingerie for someone? What if a woman says, yes, my husband did?
We'll take that.
We'll take that as
we'll
a yes?
We'll take that.
Johnny,
ladies, let us know.
Because maybe he's not
And
home.
Does it make you a little bit uncomfortable?
Don't confuse the question. There
I'm
you
not
go.
Confusing
Boom.
It. They could just... That switched it right away.
45-55. Now, women have... Yeah. So
they can just add that on as an add-on. Did it make you uncomfortable when they did?
No.
I say yes.
But the answer is
women
no.
don't like that when guys do that.
No, that's not true.
It was interesting when I asked
Expensive.
Julie
yeah.
how she would feel. And then her first question was, from John?
I know.
Yeah, for me, yes.
Yeah,
good point. Yeah,
I guess I know what Jim and I are getting
right,
here for Christmas.
Yeah,
right. Right. So, okay, it's getting closer. No, 55. Yes, 45% so far. Okay.
So, ladies, if your husband bought it for you, that will count as well. You can text in as well.
Right. Yes. If you speak for your husband.
And did it make you uncomfortable? Did you tell them, you know, why are you doing this? Yeah. Did you ask them?
That's funny. I don't want to dwell on Julie's response, but she's like, would you be uncomfortable if a man bought you lingerie? And she's like, from John? So Who does your lawn care? Like Raphael, or who is she thinking about?
Actually, she does.
I'm just wondering. She usually, yeah. Anyway, that's interesting that she kind of thought, well,
yeah,
from somebody else, yeah. So maybe she was thinking of Todd.
I don't know.
But she wasn't thinking of you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Now, if it was John Bon Jovi, she would accept that.
Right.
That's hers. You know, everybody's got that one. Hers is John Bon Jovi.
Yeah.
Yes. And Lenny Kravitz. Yeah. Who's yours?
Lenny.
Who's your wife's?
An actor?
Yeah. Todd? No?
I mean, I know her musician is Phil Collins. She's nuts over that guy. But I don't know if that would be her.
Ladies, let us know. Who would be your partner? You know, that one that's, you know.
It's a freebie.
Freebie.
Like,
exactly. It's like, yeah. Who would it be? Ladies, let us know. Yeah.
She felt really bad last night. Did she watch Survivor?
Who?
My wife.
Okay.
And
that's still on?
Yeah. Yeah.
Wow. After all those years, I remember doing a big for the first year of it, because we had that guy on. He was from Wisconsin. One of the guys on the initial Survivor was on Wisconsin.
Really?
He's from Wisconsin. Yeah. Remember, we had him on the radio station, IXX, back in the day.
Because there was a guy from Green Bay that was on where you get the roses, the dating game. It's not called the dating game.
That's really, The Bachelor.
The Bachelor.
Yeah.
He was.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. There's a guy from Green Bay on that.
Right.
His dad was a taxidermist.
Really?
Yeah. Okay. I was going to talk to Naomi about that the other day when we had her on, about her sculptures and everything like that. Because I studied to be a taxidermist. Did you know that? Yeah, what? Why are you scoffing?
The turtle. Because I
studied to be a taxidermist, Jim.
You read an article?
And that's no, I had the pamphlets. I had the whole thing.
Really?
Yes. Yes, and when she was talking about sculpturing and everything. Okay, this one here, my wife has always been crazy about Jackson Brown. Okay, all right. Thank you.
Okay,
all right.
Could happen.
No, I mounted some stuff. I mounted perch. I mounted a squirrel. I was going to mount a raccoon, but then it was my dog.
Okay.
So I didn't do that.
Don't you say taxidermed? Okay, all right.
What?
Yeah, okay.
That's this one here. My man buys me lingerie. Seldom does it fit. Clearly, he sees me much smaller than I really am.
Boy, she's
honest. That's kind of sweet, isn't it?
Yeah,
really?
She is honest.
Yeah, she is honest. Oh, 50-50 now.
There you go.
Oh,
all right.
Well, now the women are chiming in.
Yep. No, but it answers the question.
Yes.
So, okay.
Yes. Did I never told you that I was going to be a taxidermist?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, my God.
Did you see, I had that, did you see it when you were over at my house? Did you see my goat?
No.
I have a goat.
You shot one, right?
It's his head is downstairs. Kids didn't like it, so I had to put it down in. Stairs.
You didn't let us see much of your house that night.
I got a full tour.
Did you?
Almost a little too much.
I got nothing.
This is where I keep my bath towels.
I got nothing. Nothing.
Yeah. Okay. Well, anyway, I do have a taxidermy. I had the goat's head with the antlers.
Did you
stuff.
Do it yourself?
No. I had a guy do it.
Oh, okay.
No. I don't want to do it. So why didn't you pursue that career?
Okay. For one thing, with fish, when you mount fish, you got to be like an artist. You know, they paint the stuff.
The colors.
Painted.
And I have no artistic talent like that. I really wanted to do stuff like ducks, geese, birds, squirrels. I wanted to do more of the smaller stuff.
Taxiderms, whatever
that's called. A lot of people, Jim.
Squirrels?
Yeah.
Never.
There's a bar. Somebody's got to help me out on this. I want to. Hey, Todd, don't we have a station in Richland Center?
Yes, we do.
Okay. Can you contact somebody? There's a bar in Richland Center, okay, that the entire thing is of mounted squirrels, like playing cards and shooting pool and stuff like that. There's like 50 mounted squirrels in this place.
I will message Phil Nee.
Oh, my God.
Thank you.
Phil Nee right now.
Thank you.
I think he's
Richland
on the air.
Richland Center.
Oh, my God. That text we just got in. Don't read it.
I'm not going to read it.
That is hilarious. Yeah.
It's very hilarious.
That's hilarious.
Text of the day, but we can't read it. Yeah.
I was thinking the same thing.
All right, we can't
that
read that.
That is funny.
Okay, we're not going to read that one.
So Richland Center. God, that is funny. Richland Center.
Yeah, we went there. It was me and Brian Noble. We went down there. And Tony Bennett.
That's cool.
The old football player, Tony Bennett. We went down there on a turkey hunting excursion. Yes.
Well, even the Cabela's, I don't think they have squirrels, but they have a pretty good.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
And then the Tundra Lodge.
Absolutely.
They have a nice display.
Yeah.
I've never seen a squirrel. That seems like kind of small.
Well, you got to start on something, Jim.
Yeah, but I mean, I don't think I think that's probably just to like test.
Was mayor your first office? No. Yeah. You were a councilman or something, right? Or assemblyman or representative or something.
Civics.
I know less about politics and the whole thing, the way everything works, than anybody. I know less than anybody in America. And you're right. I probably shouldn't vote. Okay, this text. How many Maino stories start with, there's a bar. Right.
Like yesterday, Al Sampson and I, we'd go to this place and that place. And, yeah, that was funny.
Yeah. That was, you know what was fun with Al? We used to go around for sturgeon spearing season. And we'd go out to those little things. There's a really great little towns. Actually, we could go to some of these towns. Like, you ever hear of the town of Pipe?
Oh, no. Yes. Just north and east of Fond du Lac.
Yeah, Double Stockbridge.
Yep.
And that was one of the big registration stations for sturgeon spearing. And they make like the greatest. It's the first time I ever had this. It's a hamburger and then a big thing of cheese and onion and then a brat patty on top of that. It was so delicious. Yeah. I love those things.
Yeah, we'll go there.
Yes.
I'll go there.
Yeah.
Pipe.
It's in Calumet County. Little town, all these little mom and pop bars. And I love those kinds of places.
Yeah.
Love. You know what I still think we need to do, you and I?
Mm-hmm.
We need to restart up Frog Station. It was this great little bar gym, and you can live right upstairs of the place. We could literally live there and do the show from there. We could. It's on the way to Door County. I can't remember it was the coolest bar I've ever been in. Frog Station. Anybody out there ever been to Frog Station in the day?
What happened to it?
I think everybody just died.
Yeah.
And they just kind of, but it's there for the taking, Jim. I bet everything's still there. We can walk. It's a turnkey operation. It's my dream to own a corner bar, Jim.
Yeah. I know. That's not my dream, but.
Are you serious?
No, hell no.
Why?
It's.
You're an entrepreneur. You teach business classes.
I'm an entrepreneur.
But you don't want to do it.
I'm a capitalist. I'm an entrepreneur. Yeah. I'm not going to put my money into a bar.
No, I don't know. Oh, Sportsman's Bar in Lena had many stuffed animals. That was a Kinzinger bar. We used to stop there on the way to every Packer game. My dad and his buddy Eric would have a shot and a beer.
Yep.
And it was loaded. And we'd stop on the way back as well. Sportsman's Tavern in Lena, Wisconsin, owned by the Kinzingers. It was phenomenal. I love that place. I wonder if they still have them.
But
all that stuff.
So you've rattled off, three bars?
Yeah.
Do any of them have squirrels in there? I say no.
They do. A lot of them.
Okay.
A lot of them have squirrels.
I've never seen a stuffed squirrel.
Have you heard anything back from...
Waiting on it.
I got to get... It's a bar in Richland Center that's... Frog Station, 4 miles north of Luxemburg.
That's not that far.
I know. We could do this.
Yeah, no.
Even if... No, listen to me. Listen. How about this? We're just open Thursday, Fridays, Saturdays, and brunch on Sunday. What do you think? I want to do this. I'm not kidding. I want to do this.
I don't like idle inventory. So if it's
there's
closed,
no idle inventory.
Yeah, there is. You're closed 3 days. That would drive me nuts. No. Nope. And I think
we open Thursday. Listen.
What if then there's people that drink and then nothing that can lead to problem. I don't. Why would we want to do that? Let's do something that's.
Why? How about two words?
What?
Cha-ching. How about that?
Okay.
Why would you not want to do this?
Well, I don't know.
Thursday, Friday, Saturdays, and a Sunday brunch. And that's it. Yes or no?
If this is such a cha-ching, why aren't they still operating?
Because I need a partner with money.
Why don't they?
Yeah. And I need somebody with a business head. You got a business brain.
John, no.
You teach classes on this. This would be like a test tube thing for your students.
Test tube.
We could get them to work there for free to give them some experience.
That's true. Yeah. That is true. We could get some cheap labor with students. That is true. And they would like that. And we could talk about, you know, our marketing.
Exactly.
Customer service.
Absolutely.
Profit.
Absolutely.
Yep. How are we going to price it? And we'll do that surge pricing. We'll raise our prices when we're super busy.
No, we're not doing that.
Yeah.
No, we're not doing that.
The lowest guaranteed price in Wisconsin. That's what we're going to do.
Oh,
yes,
sell on
thank
price.
You, Todd.
What
Todd, are you in with me on this?
What a good idea.
Todd's
sell
in.
On price.
Todd is in on this. Hey, Todd.
So your business strategy is to sell on price.
And you know
price.
We're going to have a year, 1 year from today?
And what happens when somebody...
You know what's going to be 1 year from today, Jim? Lingerie day. Mino and the mayor.
I'll tell you what we won't be doing is dropping ping pong balls from the
exactly
sky.
Exactly.
I can tell you that much.
I'm telling you.
Yep. I'm throwing this out there, and I'm dead serious, people. Is there anybody that'd like to invest with me on reclaiming Frog Station? Only open 3 nights a week.
Is that the place that would flood and they would get water?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's another.
I remember the floor was plus. A little slanted too, where you play pool in there.
Nice.
Yeah. And you just hit the ball, it'll just roll to like one corner. It just did out its own. And they're they had a quarter jukebox.
Yeah.
With all the great old state Johnny Cash. I hear the train a coming. It's rolling
but that's
around
great.
The bend.
It floods. I the floor is on a slant.
We can fix that
what
stuff.
What else?
Okay, we got people,
money,
Jim.
Money. Money. Cost yes. money to fix stuff like we talked to that guy yesterday.
You can be a silent part.
The guy, like we talked to that guy yesterday, Johnny, he just said that one of the reasons he's pocketing so much money is he's not into the bricks and mortar.
I realized that, Jim.
Which is really smart because you tie a lot of money up. You got insurance and then you got upkeep and repairs. And
I will,
that was smart
this.
What
I will,
he did
here, I will do this.
That
I will guarantee
impressive.
You, if you take part in this,
yeah,
if you back me on this, okay, I will give you, every night we're open, I'll give you $100 cash.
Yeah, no, that's not
the government won't have to know anything about it.
No, I would never do that.
You would do it in a heartbeat. Heartbeat. I'd give you five $20 bills every night.
On the air, he says no.
Yeah,
behind the scenes.
Behind the scenes.
We should talk about this.
Let's talk about that. I want him in tens, though. I want tens. Give me tens.
I'll take 20.
And then we take some of the jukebox money, too. Yeah.
No. But anyway, that's nice. You have that. You have a lot of ambitions.
I do.
And I think that's... you're going to live a long time.
I've always wanted to own a neighborhood bar
and
all my
be
life.
Be a taxidermist and build houses and, you know.
Oh, by the way.
Yeah, we got a guy coming on.
Yeah, we got a guy coming on who's living my dream. But I just heard that commercial, Todd, right before we started about apprentice carpenters.
Oh, yeah.
I want to do that. But is it really 4 years? Can I accelerate it to like 6 months?
Mm.
4 months?
I don't know.
I'm not sure I'm going to be as proficient in 4 years as I am right now. That's a long time. You know what I mean?
I think you're a little bit more advanced than some.
That's what I mean. Nothing. So I think I could. Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Test out a bit.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think they should allow you to do that. I think you.
Yeah.
I mean, you would probably pick up a year.
Okay. I want to do that. I'm serious. I'm still so disappointed that no home builders have contacted me.
Yeah, John.
I'm offering my labor. Minimum wage. Minimum wage. I will work for you.
$7.75.
We got to set our break, but Karen's joining us soon. Stay with us. Was that odd? Did that go in the air? What he said, Todd? Oh,
oh
my goodness.
The mic was on. I was just giving a thumbs up and he goes,
wow. Jim.
Jim is now up to a total of $40 on the fines.
Oh, man. But did you hear what he said?
It didn't come across.
It did or did not?
It did not. Just his grunt.
Lucky.
Just his grunt.
Okay.
Oh.
All right.
Just his grunt.
We were.
You just saved your career.
I think I did. We were. Just, well, John, I took it out of the news.
Still, the way you put it.
That's because it's true.
I'm just saying.
I was reading the paper. Okay. And I'm reading the paper. I was reading it online, the news, because I enjoyed doing
it. Okay, there's a picture of Frog Station. Somebody sent us a picture.
Oh, cool.
Who sent us a picture, Todd?
I believe it was Terry.
Terry.
John.
What?
No
way. It needs a little work, but not.
Oh, my God.
What?
No, not even. I wasn't thinking about it before, but now I'm, like, not even thinking about it a little bit. That's, nope. I ain't going to buy that.
Look at us. You could live upstairs. We could live upstairs.
Look at the infrastructure the city is doing.
Okay, the road's got a big deal.
Streets
got some
all cracked.
Big deal.
There's no, the curb's not any good. There's no landscaping. Would you go into that place? I would not.
I've been in that place 20 times, 50 times.
Yeah, no. That ain't going to happen.
Serious.
Serious.
Well, there's
serious.
My dream right there.
Yeah, that's nice.
I'm living there. I'm running the bar.
Low expectations. That's good.
No,
that's,
it's not. Yeah. I can fix that up.
Right on the corner. Nice little corner location.
Absolutely. All the tourists in the summer get that Chicago money. My God.
Where is, what road is
cha-ching,
that?
Cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching.
What road is that?
I don't know,
Jim. Okay, that's not, if it's on 42.
It's on a main road.
It is?
Yeah.
Didn't look like it.
It is. Well, that picture, it might not, but yeah, it's really busy. Well,
that's not a highway. That's a county road.
I talked to the transportation department one time, and they said it's like 400,000 cars go through there in a week.
They did not.
Jim, I did some market research because you told me that's what you need to do before you go into business.
And you have to. Yeah,
and I checked it out.
You got to vet it. But okay.
Yes, I vetted it.
Yeah. So, no, we were.
Oh, by the way, that was Tori that sent that in.
Thanks, Tori.
And he also said it's County Road A, B, and K.
Okay. Very popular road.
Mark from New Franken says, I live by Frog Station. It's been flooded so many times. It's trash.
Well,
okay, Mark. There's your research right there.
Hey, Mark.
Right there.
You want to know what you can do, Mark? Hey, Mark, how does it feel? Mark, how does it feel to kill somebody's dreams? Wow.
So
flooding can be fixed. Flooding can be fixed.
Why did they fix it?
Huh? They died. They died.
I've got a couple of those bars in Richland Center that came through.
Yes.
The Press Box.
Maybe.
Mel's Micro.
Maybe.
Bunker Hill.
Maybe.
Jungle Bar.
Could be.
Jungle Bar has a dirt floor.
Okay.
Oh, jeez.
Okay. So it could be one of those.
It's got like 100 stuffed squirrels.
Yeah. He actually said there's a few around here that have that.
Oh, really? Yeah. Okay. That must be a popular thing then in that area. Just a big turkey hunting area. Richland Center. Yeah.
Where's that?
Southwest part of the state. Right in the Wisconsin River. Right, Todd?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. So yes. There.
And we have a station there.
Yes, we do.
Got two stations. Yep.
We have two.
And you know what we're going to do?
We're going to go.
Tuesday road trip. We're going there one time.
Let's switch with those guys. You know, well, that'd be fun, right? Because we have 21. What? Civic Media owns 21 stations.
Yes.
Let's do that like swap. Like how people like swap. Remember that?
Oh, yeah. Murphy did that time with IXX. Yeah. They got in big trouble. I don't think
the people in Richland Center would take to you guys.
Why?
I think they're a little bit more conservative.
Why are you talking to two pretty conservative guys?
You know, that's funny.
I don't know that they would talk about lingerie day.
Oh, you know what I'm saying? I got you. I thought you meant politically or something.
Okay.
You know, I'm going to tell you something funny, Todd. I just told a story the other day about, so I used to get my hair permed.
Yeah. A lot of people did.
Got this text. Flooding is fine. You can have a swim-up bar. Think about it. A lot of possibilities here, Jim.
Play cards.
I'm buying that place. I'm buying Frog Station. I need a partner. Anybody else want to help me? Let me know. I'm just saying. I used to get a perm.
Yeah.
So I had really curly hair, and it was, you know. So.
Well, perms give you curly hair. What do you mean?
Well, I did it, so I stopped fighting trying to make my hair straight.
So you just went curly.
I went curly.
Okay.
Yeah.
You just gave in and said, look, if I'm going to be curly, curl it up.
Exactly.
Okay. All right. Okay. Got it.
And I was on TV in Twin Falls, Idaho. Okay. And I got contacted by a station in Midland, Odessa, Texas. Wow. And they said, hey, you were looking at some tapes. We saw your thing. Were you interested in coming to Texas and doing sports? Huge high school football area. You know, the whole thing. I'm like, yeah.
Wow.
That'd be awesome. So I sent them the tape and everything. And the guy, I still remember playing his day. And the guy goes, hey, man, I really like your work. Boy, you cover a lot of sports. I go, yeah, a lot of local sports here. Man, we love that. That's huge here. He goes, just one thing. we're a pretty conservative area. And your hair, honest to God. I go, yeah, what about my hair? He goes, well, like I said, we're pretty conservative.
Wow.
And we're not sure that would go over here. And wow. I'm like, I don't think I'm moving to Midland, Texas because they had the big Afro type thing and he wasn't going to hire me because of my hair.
Wow. But you could have gotten rid of that, right? You could have shaved it down a little bit.
I know, but it was just the attitude of your hair. Really?
What's next?
That's the South.
What's
that? That is the South.
I was going to say that. Oh my God. You know what else I was going to ask you about, Todd? Have you heard about this bug that's invading Mississippi and Alabama?
Oh, yeah, everybody.
Cicadas?
Has.
Yeah. Cicadas.
Cicadas. What are those?
Those are the things in the summer that you hear squealing in the trees and stuff.
But up here?
Yep. But up here as well. And there's this huge thing this year where.
Because there's two brands coming up, right? At the same time, they've both been dormant for a while.
They've been dormant for a while. So this year, we're going to have a lot of cicadas.
They're like overtaking some of these towns. And they're so loud, they said people are calling the cops.
Right. Yeah.
Wow.
I don't think that's as big up here, though, is it?
We have cicadas up here.
Are they like a grasshopper, sort of? Or cricket?
I'll see if I can find a picture.
Yeah.
I don't know what they are.
Yeah, they're all coming out of the ground.
But they said there's just swarms of them are taking over some towns.
Yeah.
Where it's like insane. Whatever happened to those killer bees? Remember they used to say from Texas that those killer bees
were coming? Oh, we were all worried we're going to die.
Yeah, remember that? Because a couple of guys did die. I remember a rancher like in Texas died. Could get stung to death. Wouldn't that be a way to go?
Oh.
We need to ask big. Oh, wow. That almost looks like it'd be good bait for fishing. Just colorful and everything. How big are they, Todd?
They're not that big. No. Maybe about.
Oh, that could say, you could use that for bait. Wow.
Well, somebody, if you, the here's where I'll invest. You find a use for those things. I'm in.
Okay.
If that's, if you can
that
trap
would be great
them,
bait.
If you can trap them.
Yeah. And sell them at a bait shop.
Yep. I, if that, now that, because you can really make a lot of money if you're cost of goods is zero.
Okay.
And now you're going back to selling worms. I mean, basically, is
we
what,
could
right?
sell. There you go. We could sell night crawlers. And my sister, let me tell you something.
You're onto something.
My sister won a trip to the National Science Fair convention in Kansas City, and her thing was night crawlers.
Yeah.
Night crawlers were a big part of my family.
Yes.
Big part of growing up. We had 1,000 night crawlers in our basement.
By a frog station, throw a bait.
A bait shop and back. Yep. Not even a question.
All right, we're moving on.
Cha-ching, cha-ching.
Who's next, Johnny?
Larry McCarron, away next.
All right.
Back after this.